let's perform a thought experiment. The year is 2120 and human cloning is legal. The technique has been perfected and your clone is now a flawless 100% physical replica of yourself. Does that mean that your clone will think and act exactly the same as you do? Would it be possible to clone all your memories and thoughts? Would you and your clone have the exact same personality? While we do not have human clones to demonstrate this practically, here are some of the facts that show that your clone could be very different from the original you. But first, you need to know what cloning is and how the technique works. In cloning, researchers take the nucleus, which contains your genetic material, from one of your cells and injects it into an egg whose own nucleus has been removed. The resulting embryo, which will carry your nucleus and hence your DNA, in every one of its cells, is then implanted into the womb of a surrogate mother who carries the embryo to term. This will result in an individual who may look exactly like you, but your clone will not be you. While you will be sharing some of the genetic makeup, his or her mind will not be exactly like yours. Your clone may react similarly to you in some situations, while in others, very differently. This is because we are more than a product of our genes. While genes help determine traits, environmental influences have a considerable impact on shaping an individual's physical appearance and personality. Your clone will be exposed to different environments and technologies than you were, and those will shape them to be very different from you. To understand this, take the example of identical twins. Identical twins are natural clones from the same egg, sharing the same genetic makeup. But studies show that even identical twins raised in different environments have different personalities. So, likewise, your clone will have its own personality, character, intelligence, and talents. Another difference between your clone and you is the mitochondria in your cells. Mitochondria are organelles present in every cell. Known as the powerhouse of the cell, their job is to burn fuel from the food we eat to make energy. Mitochondria have their own chromosome, made of DNA and divided into genes, and they divide as our cells divide. We get our mitochondria from our mothers. Egg cells are packed with mitochondria, which are copied and distributed to new cells as they form. So, the mitochondrial DNA in your clone will come from the egg donor, which will be different from yours. Cloning is a way to create an embryo, not a full-grown individual. Your clones won't be your age unless they are cloned right after you were conceived. Your clone will need a surrogate mother and ample time to grow and fully develop into an individual. The surrogate mother of your clone might also be different from your mother, which creates a huge difference. And even if it is your mother, science shows that no two pregnancies are the same. What this means is that even if you wanted to, you cannot duplicate your identical self. Even if you were to clone yourself several times, you would not be able to create the exact same person each time, because every human life, no matter how or when it is conceived, is unique.